Alright guys, so I'm gonna make a little video on how to rap and kinda break it down a little bit, cause a lot of people have been asking me like, how do you do it and all this other stuff. I haven't done it in a while. It's been a couple months since I've done it, so hopefully I still remember how to do it. And hopefully I have enough rap, cause I'm using some leftover rap from the roll that I used to wrap the whole car. So hopefully I have enough. But so yeah, I'm gonna be wrapping this bumper. First step is to like make sure you clean your area, make sure that there's no dust and stuff. I might have to close the garage because it's a bit windy and I don't want there to be any dust blowing into the sticky part of the wrap. And you know, wipe down all the panels, make sure that, you know, nothing is gonna stick to the wrap. Wipe it down. I have some alcohol that I'm gonna wipe it down with. Alcohol is not gonna do damage to the fiberglass or the primary house, so it should be good. Yeah, it's also, the alcohol is also safe to wipe down the like real paint, like how I did with my car. So I wiped the bumper down like maybe 7 times because it was filthy. You can still kind of tell there's some dirt right there. I'm probably gonna have to wipe it down one more. So if you have a painted car, I suggest you clay bar it. Little bar of clay, spray it with water, and then you just grab that little piece of clay and you just rub it, and it'll literally take all the grime and dirt off it, and then it won't scratch it or anything. It'll leave your car or your paint so nice. So these are the tools that you're gonna need. So if you have a painted car, a clay bar, a spray bottle with water, and you're gonna need a squeegee, X-Acto knife, or these knives. I like these ones because if it gets dull, you can just break it off and have a sharp new blade. I think I got this at Home Depot for like $1. And a tack wipe. You don't really need it, but I like to use it because it'll get all the lint off the bumper and stuff. If you use one of these, make sure you wear gloves or something, because it'll leave your hands so sticky. And then of course your alcohol wipes, which I have over there. Make sure you wipe down good, that way it doesn't have any oil or grease. So I'm gonna give this one more wipe. This zip tight on just for right now, that way if I need to take the bumper off when I need to do the bottom, it'll be easy. If any of you guys are trying to rock this bumper, how I mounted all my license plate stuff, I cut this out. That way my license plate lights and my rear view camera can go under there, and then my plate's gonna be right here. The plastic that holds all of that stuff, even the trunk release, just press in between here and then just put your screws through. As well with the blinker is pretty self-explanatory. There's 2 brackets there already. Hopefully Mehmed gets here. That way he can help me pull the roll out and, you know, lay it on. All right guys, so all of you guys that are wondering how much wrap I had left is all of this. It's probably like 10 feet. After I wasted 10 feet on the hood on my first try. Wipe it down with the wipe, you know, make sure there's no lint on it. It looks all right. Crucial parts are like where the wrap is gonna go around and like hold itself, cause then like, you gotta watch out for that, cause or else it'll peel over time. So we're gonna try to cut this now or get it up. And then just lay it on the bumper.
Look, this tape. We just put a smiley emoji over it, covered.
Dude, this tape won't stick, dude. What the fuck?
Seriously. You can see this.
Holy moly, that's so much wrap still.
Bad bitch, small waist, pretty face. Having my way,
having.
She let me nut on the face. Stay in your place,
stay in your.
Shut up and stay out the way.
Shut up.
Decided what I'm gonna do today.
What?
I'ma ghost ride the rave.
Ghost.
I'ma ghost ride the rave. I wanna look at the stars today.
Ghost.
I'ma ghost ride the rave.
Ghost.
I'ma ghost ride the rave.
Ghost.
I'ma ghost ride the rave. Thinking about copping that dime today. I'ma ghost ride the rave.
Ghost.
I'ma ghost ride the rave.
Take off.
I'ma ghost ride the rave. I'ma ghost ride like I'm from the Bay.
So this is what I've done so far. One tip on wrapping is make sure you stretch it out as much as you can. as much as you can, just like this, like right here is not even touching. Try to stretch it out as much as you can. That way you can just like kind of just glaze over it. Don't push down on it just in case you need to pull up on the wrap. When you're gonna squeegee, don't go in every direction. Go all even, because you'll basically be stretching the wrap and then you'll end up getting wrinkles like how I did here. I have no idea how I'm gonna get that out. I thought I was gonna, I totally ignored it, and I was like, oh, I'll try to, maybe I'll get it out somehow. When I cut this open, I might be able to push up on it and heat gun it and then push down. Make sure that the wrap doesn't stick to itself like how it happened here. Hopefully I can just pull it up and then heat gun it and then stretch it. That way this rip is like on the bottom of the bumper. It's like right at the edge. If not, I'll just lay a strip of wrap over it and it'll be fine. So like right here, just, you know, keep squeegeeing. Take your time. Don't rush it, because the more you rush it, the more you're gonna fuck up. It's better to take it slow. Don't push this way on like with the wrinkles. Work them out like this. You guys are gonna come across this issue, especially on a curvy ass bumper like this. It'll just try to wrinkle up on you. What I do is I just heat gun it a little bit, and then you can either do it with the squeegee, but I like to do it with the finger. And then just kind of push it out. So you guys come across this issue, just do that. This is another really bad part right here. It just basically happens because, as you can tell, there's a lot of tension on this part of the wrap, and right here there isn't. That's why it's wrinkling up. So that's why I like to heat gun it and then remove all the tension that's on this. Or, well, give it tension all the way till it matches tension on this, or you could either release this tension, but I'd rather not, because it's nicely stretched out and this isn't, so I'd rather stretch this out. Heat gun that area, and I literally just pulled the wrap down. All right, so first I'm gonna try to squeegee these out, make sure that the wrap is nice and flat, and then like all the tension wanted to go this way, so pull it that way. You know what? Let me lower this a little bit. You could also, instead of stretching it out, you could also just like keep it nice and loose how it is here, but you know. Put the wrap back to normal, and then just squeegee it out. I was gonna stretch it out for you guys, but it's gonna be better if I just do it this way. I don't like to go directly like this to those, because then that's when you crease them. So be careful with that. Always try to like wrap all evenly. So right here, I'm gonna try to catch this corner up. Heat gun it. And just go down. Now, if you guys are wrapping in a place where it's like really cold, it's gonna be harder for you guys to wrap, because I've noticed that when the wrap is cold and it sticks to itself, it's just gonna tear. So make sure you're in a warm area, I guess. Is what I'm trying to say, because I didn't know until like I started wrapping this bumper. I guess the temperature outside does affect it, which kind of makes sense. This part right here, I just started trying to crumple up. Don't be afraid to yank on it as well. That seems to help a lot. Now the wrap is pretty durable if you know how to control it. Let's say when you're going in the curve where it's like deep in and everything's sticking out, just heat gun the whole area. That way the material stretches, so when you lay it out, it's like laying down nice and easy. But But you see how I'm only squeegeeing this, and the reason for that is because this side's way lower, so I'm trying to catch the rest of the wrap up. That way, when I pull on it, it's all gonna be evenly pulled out. Just take your time, guys, honestly. Don't get all like, oh, I gotta finish it, or what the fuck, you know, trying to find the fast ways to do it. Like, no. You literally have to be the wraps, bitch. Yeah, I know, it kind of sucks. I hate being told what to do, but fuck, dude. If you want quality, dude, just take your time. Well, there's this huge wrinkle right here, and it's like stuck to itself. So watch. Literally, it just goes away. Look how nice that worked out. Fuck, this is so satisfying. Okay, dude, the last fucking squeegees are gonna be so nice. She's touching it, boys. But there's an air bubble right here. Maybe, okay. What I like to do is just use the corner of the squeegee and just kind of circle around it, and bam, gone. Look at that, boys, we going America. So then, to wrap it all the way around, I'm just gonna like push up against this. And I'm literally just gonna grab the heat gun, heat the gun out of it, and just fucking stretch it all the way down. I'm gonna wrap it around under. Good meme. I'm just gonna heat gun it. Oh, would you look at that? Bam! So the bumper is fully wrapped. The bottom's all trimmed. Take it off now and do the top and install it and then fucking put the wing on. Oh, and this piece right here, remember how there is a rip in it? Yeah, there's no more rip. I just literally continued installing it. You can't even see it. And I just put just one piece of wrap right there. And you can't even tell there's two pieces right there. It looks fully wrapped.